Hello friends. In this tutorial, I will teach you how to use physics and how to interact and change the direction of objects in animation. By enabling physics and its settings, instead of spending a lot of time creating keyframes, we use physics or the law of gravity. For example, if I play this animation, you can see how the objects interact with each other. Now, if I hide one of these circles and press the play button again, you can see that the movement of the other circle changes without creating new keyframes. In another example, if I hit the play button, you can see how the ball moves and the ball eventually stops. I will create a new worksheet to teach how to use physics settings. I draw a rectangle with the shape tool and change its color. I create a point in the center of the rectangle and drag it down. I create more arc for this point with curvature tool and dragging, so that the ball moves in this direction. I create a new vector layer and name it ball. I draw a circle and change its color. I put the ball in the starting place. I make a duplicate of the ball layer and rename it. I change the color of the new ball. I select three layers and put them all in a group with right click. I put the ball in the center. I double click on the layer group and select the physics section. Now I activate enable physics. Here I can determine the direction of gravity, which is the default number of 270. Here we can determine the strength of gravity, the number 10 is suitable and I press the OK button. I double click on the rectangle layer and select the physics section. Now, because I don't want this shape to move, I activate the non-moving object option so that gravity does not affect this layer. I press the OK button. I double click on the blue ball layer. Enters the physics section. Here we can change the initial direction of the ball. Here we can determine the initial speed of movement. I set the number 1 for density. You have to change these numbers in different animations to create the right movement for the shape. For friction, I set a value of 0.30. And for springiness, I set the number to 0.50. I press the OK button. I double click on the orange ball layer. In the physics section, I select the start asleep option so that the ball moves when it hits. Now I press the play button, you can see that the interaction of balls and objects works correctly. And the software has automatically created keyframes. If I hide the orange ball and press the play button, you can see the movement of the blue ball without hitting the orange ball. Now I double click on the group layer and activate this option and press the play button. You can see that the type of movement of the balls changes a little. I return the setting to the previous state. If I double click on the blue ball layer and change the numbers from the physics section and hit the play button, you can see that the blue ball's movement increases a lot. So you need to determine the appropriate numbers for the shape movement in this section. There are exactly the same settings in the other scene. One layer for the ball and one layer for the shapes in the scene. And both layers are in the same group. And if I double-click on the ball layer, you can see its settings. I double-click on this layer and because I don't want the shapes to move, I activated the non-moving object option. Thank you for being with me until the end of this tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Bye until the next video.